Hey everyone, and once again, welcome to Google Ads Course. Myself, Umar Taskeer. Guys, in this particular video, we are going to see the walkthrough of very famous Google search type of campaigns or Google search type of ads. So we'll not be talking about these type of ads or campaigns in very detail in this specific video, because for that purpose, we are having a complete module. So the different settings, the different levels, the different options that we get within the Google search ad, those things, those all things we'll be discussing in the complete module, like in next we can say that 10 or 12 or 15 videos, right? That those videos will be dedicated to Google search type of ad only. But in this particular video, just to make sure that how it actually looks and what kind of interface this ad system provides us for running Google search ads, we are going to have a walkthrough of all the levels that we have into any campaign, specifically in the search campaign. And we have to keep the things in mind that whenever you are running Google ads, suppose you are running Google search ad, never think that same kind of settings, same kind of approach will be there for all kind of businesses, all kind of niche, right? According to the niche, according to the nature of the business, according to your objective, you have to apply different settings. For example, in the previous video, as we discussed about Google search network and Google display network, now we have the option that whether we want to select Google Display Network only or whether we want to select Google Search Network only. Now, there is no sure shot formula that we should go for Google Search Network only or we should go for Google Display Network only. It totally depends on our objective, our goal, or what kind of business we are running, what thing we are looking to achieve, right? So, if we know about our goals, if we know about our objectives, if we know about our business, that will help us in deciding whether we should go for Google Search Network only or Google Display Network only, or we should opt this hybrid strategy where our ads will be showing on Google Search Network also as well as on Google Display Network also. So there is no sure shot formula that, okay, just go to Google, click on campaign, select this search network, do the second step and so on, and then your campaign will be there, right? So it is not going to work that way. It is not going to work, right? What you have to understand is there are different options, there are different settings, and those different settings work in different scenarios. There can never be a simple way or simple path that, okay, this is step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have to follow this thing and now you are making your golden campaign. It is not going to work that way, right? So now, in this specific video, as I told you, I'm not going to discuss in very detail about the different settings, the options that we are having in Google search campaigns. The thing that we are going to do is just we are going to have an overview so that we can understand how this actually works and what kind of settings, what kind of levels are there and what kind of settings are at what level, right? So let's begin. So everything starts with the campaign in Google Ads, whether you are running search campaign or display campaign, app install campaign, video campaign, shopping campaign, whatever you are doing, everything starts with the campaign after the creation of your Google Ads account. So here it is. Once we are into our Google Ads, as you can see on my laptop screen, and the account that I am using that we created in the very first video or the second video for the purpose of learning this course. So this one is the account that we are going to use in further videos also for creating other accounts or the other platforms, right? So let's begin, and we can simply start by clicking this new campaign over here, and we can click on this new campaign. Now they are asking us to decide the goal, right? So if we are expert, we do not have any goal over here, right? And we want to start the things from the very scratch. We know each and everything. We know each and every settings. We want the complete control to us. Then we can start with this create a campaign without a goal. Now, what is the basic difference between these objectives and without this goal guidance, right? So when you are going for this goal, right, there are some predefined settings which are already there. Like, if you are going for website traffic, now they know that, okay, you want website traffic. So these settings are recommended for you. So they will by default select those settings for you. They means the Google Ads, right? Google Ads system that will select some by default settings for you, because now you have opted for website traffic as your goal or your objective. But when I am saying that, okay, I wanted to create a campaign without a goal guidance, which means that I know each and everything. I know my goals and objectives. Give me a basic plain canvas and I'll design my campaign by myself, right? So this is basically the major difference between the goals that you are having over here, like you are having 3, 4, and 3, 6, 7, right? 7 goals you are having over here, and then you are having a plain canvas where you can draw anything, right? Where you can create anything. So we'll be following this thing right now. I'll be telling you about these things also and how they basically differ, how they practically differ when we compare it with without a goal guidance or with some goals, right? So I'll be telling you later also. Now, for now, we will be clicking on this create a campaign without a goal guidance, because I wanted you to see the maximum settings which are going to appear into this section only, because this is the plain canvas, right? So now when we say that, okay, we wanted to create a campaign without a goal guidance, now they are telling us that whether we wanted to create a campaign which is search, display, they are giving us the option. But for now, we will be sticking ourselves to search. As soon as I'm clicking on the search, right now I am having 3 options over here, right? So if we want website traffic, which is very common, we can simply click on website visits, and then we can put our website address over here. If it is required, it is not compulsory. It is actually not compulsory. If you want to put, you can simply put it over here. And if you want to leave it blank, you can do that thing also, right? Now we'll be clicking on this continue. Now they are saying that you already have a saved campaign and we do not want to resume from there. We just want to start anew. So we'll do this, right? And now it is telling us that, okay, your search settings are here. General search settings are here. And your campaign type is search. Now we have to put a campaign name, which we have to decide by ourselves. So right now I am putting demo campaign. And now this option comes over here, which basically I told you in the previous video, right? We discussed about this, that there are search networks. So if you wanted to show your ad on search network only, which is basically, if we say only search network, which means that Google search. But if we click on this include Google search partner, this will basically include the websites like we discussed W3 schools, right? So we can uncheck this, and we can uncheck this thing also. I'll not recommend you anything over here right now in this specific video, because we are just doing a simple walkthrough. So these kind of settings we are having over here at this campaign setting level. We can decide about the network that we want to move with. Now coming down, we have more settings which are like start and end date, when you want to start your campaign. Your campaign URL options are there. This is basically for your tracking purpose. Then there is dynamic search ad settings. Then there are schedule, that at what schedule you want to run your ad. This is again a very important thing. If you run any shop or something, any business which basically operates in a certain time period, right? In certain times, and you want to receive calls, so you want to receive footfalls in those specific time only, then this option is good for you. Now, coming to targeting and audiences, this is again a very important thing. You have location targeting, where you want to show your ad. You can select all the countries and territories. This is huge. You need a lot of budget to go for this. Then you can select the complete India, or if you wanted to select a specific city, region, anything, you can include or exclude that thing also. So you have locations control over here, and this location control is within the campaign setting. Now this is another very important thing that we have to remember, right? We have to remember that what kind of setting is there at what level. This thing should be very clear. And now this section, targeting an audience, we have to come down, and then we have languages over here, and we can easily decide what kind of language we want to target. Then we have audiences over here, and then we have budget, right? How much amount we want to spend each day. Now they are asking, enter the average amount you want to spend each day. So we can put our amount over here, like 500 rupees, just a demo amount over here. Now there comes the very complicated part, which is basically the bidding. How you want your amount to be spent, right? You want maximum clicks, you want maximum impressions, you want maximum conversions. What you actually want, is that you can decide over here, and based on those settings only, your ad will participate into Google auction, right? So these are the different settings that we are basically having at campaign level. Okay, the major settings are general settings, this one, some more general settings over here, and then there is targeting and audiences, which are basically location, languages and audiences. Then there is budget and bidding, which is over here, the amount that we want to spend and how we want to spend that amount. Like we want maximize clicks, like we want maximum clicks, we want maximum conversions, whatever we want, we can put it over here. And then we have some more settings over here. We wanted to define conversion, that okay, what is conversion for us? If anyone is coming to onto this page, if anyone is coming onto our thank you page, that is basically a conversion for us. This is, these kind of settings are over there. And then we have ad extensions. If you do not know about the ad extension, let me show you what is basically the ad extension. Let me come to google.com first, okay, and let me put some keywords so that I can trigger ad, like digital marketing course. Here it is. Now you can see this one is the ad, this one is the ad, and these are basically the extensions that you are seeing. This is the site link extension, the extra thing that comes over here. Now you have the control to put this thing over here, right? And they basically increase your CTR, right? Because it looks impressive. See, if anyone coming onto your ad or seeing your ad is more likely to click here with if we compare it with this thing, right? So this is the basic ad without any extension, right? This one is having two extensions. One is call extension over here, and another one is site link extension over here, right? So these are the extensions that we can create, and these all things can be created at campaign level only. Now we have to move to next level, and now they are saying that okay, we have to decide any location over here, because without location we cannot move further. Now we have to click on the save and continue. Now we'll be redirected to the second level, which is ad group level. Now ad group level only constitutes the keyword thing, right? So we can put some keywords over here, and we can put those keywords in form of these different match types that we will be discussing later. But yes, ad group is basically a collection of keywords as well as ads. But ads are there at the next level, which is showing over here. But right now we have this ad group. Suppose we wanted to promote SEO course. So we are putting over here SEO course, and we'll put some URL over here also. So that will fetch something. So let's say we are putting this URL and clicking on this get keyword. Now it will give us some suggestions. I'll not recommend you to use all these suggestions. I'll always recommend you to go to keyword planner and do proper research of the keywords, pick the keywords from there, and then use them into your campaign. Or you can also enter your product or services. Like I'm closing this thing for now, and I'm putting like SEO course, okay, SEO course, and we'll click on update keywords, and then I'll be clicking on SEO course, or we can say that SEO course in Hindi. So this is basically for the suggestion purpose. Yes, replace. Fine, this is basically for the suggestion purpose. So now as soon as I'm putting some we can say that seed keyword over here, or some ideas over here, we are getting much more keywords over here, right? So we can select further more keywords from here, and then we have two options over here. One is basically the website. You can put the website and you can get some keyword ideas and use them into your ad group. And you can put some product or services or kind of a seed keywords over here, and then you will be getting some ideas over here. You have the power to decide whether you want to use these keywords into your ad group or not. But let me explain you very clearly. Keyword are very important things. I mean, one of the most important things in Google search ad. We cannot ignore these keywords. So I'll recommend you to research about keywords, and do not only go for the suggestions. Do proper research, look for the volume of the keywords, look for their competition, look for their bidding, look for the keywords which your competitors are ranking for, right? Do all those things, do all that kind of research, then only put those keywords into your ad group. Now they are giving you just some suggestions. You have to do a lot of research from here onwards, right? As we also discussed before, that we have the power of creating, or we have the options of creating multiple ad groups in the single campaign. So once we created this ad group, now we have new ad group option over here also. So we can create another ad group with another themed keyword set, right? So similar kind of keywords will be there in one ad group, and then other kind of keywords will be there into another ad group. So we cannot mix those things, right? Two different type of keywords or two different bunch of keywords should not be there into a single ad group. It is not recommended. It will reduce our relevancy. That is what we are discussing from the very second or third video, that anything which hampers the relevancy and which basically confuses the Google that okay, the things are not relevant, is not good for you as advertiser, and it is also not good for your budget. So that thing you have to keep in your mind. Now we will come to this third part. Let's click on this save and continue, and come to this third part, which is basically creation of the ad. So now this is the actual copy. So you need to create your ads over here and make sure that you are following Google's policy, because as soon as you are violating any of Google policy, your ad will not be approved. Now that will create a problem for you, right? So if you're a beginner, I'll never recommend you to pick up the businesses which are actually in gray area. So if you are picking up the businesses which are actually in gray area or some kind of, they can be banned or they can violate the policies of Google. If you think like that, please do not jump into those businesses. Do not jump into those kind of projects, right? Start with basic projects first. Start with which are very clean, white kind of projects first, and then go to those gray projects, right? Now, you have to create your complete ad over here. Like you have to, first of all, you have to put your final URL over here, like I am doing. I am putting this final URL. This is basically where we want to drive the traffic. So this one is the final URL. And then we can design the complete ad, that how our ad should look. So like I'm writing SEO course in Hindi, fine. And best or number one, we can write here, number one SEO course in India, complete SEO process in depth. This is how we are going to create, right? This is how you are going to create. Now we will put courses, we will put Hindi over here or SEO over here. And then we have to put the description. Now you can relate this thing with this thing, right? So we have headlines over here. We have this display URL over here, which is this one, right? Display path over here. And then we have these descriptions over here. So our ad is basically, the ad copy in the search ad is basically divided into three parts. First one is your final URL that is going to appear over here, your headings part and your description part. Along with that, there comes another very important thing, which is basically ad extension that we discussed at that campaign level setting, right? So this is basically a walkthrough of Google search ad, and we can create multiple ads over here. As we are creating our first ad, now we are getting another option over here. We can create multiple ads. We can click on this done and create next ad for the third one. And yes, we do need to create multiple ads, that we will discuss later also, that we need to create multiple ads also. This is the requirement, that we have to create multiple ads for the testing purpose. Let Google decide that which ad is performing best for us, or we can figure out which ad is performing best for us. So we can move on with that ad and pause other ads which are there. So this is how it is going to work. When everything is okay, we'll be clicking on done, and then our this ad section will be completed, right? Now we'll be clicking on save and continue, and there comes the final process, which says the review, right? So if we have any issues, they will tell us that okay, your info is not complete, as they are telling us in this specific case, because we didn't bother much about the settings, we were just doing a simple walkthrough, right? So guys, once you reach this review, you'll see some information related to what you have entered so far. And then you have to check that information, whether it is correct or not. It is kind of a double check for you. You have to check that, and then you have to click on this publish. As soon as you'll click on publish, your campaign will go into review, right? It will go into review, and if everything is good, everything is perfect, it will get approved, and after some time it will start showing you the results, right? And if it is not up, they will reject your ad, and they will tell you the reasons of rejection. Now you can alter your ad. I mean, once your ad got disapproved and you got the reason for disapproval, you have to check the reasons of disapproval and make sure that your ads follow the policies of Google, then only you will be able to run ads on Google, right? So that's it for this specific video. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.